Hey, this is Pooja Puneet. Welcome to Pooja's Perspective, where I answer your questions every Wednesday. Today's question comes from Monica, who's from Delhi. She says, "Hi Pooja, I love watching your videos. They are very inspirational." Thanks for that. "I can easily buy and do things for my parents, husband, kids, in-laws, but if I buy something for myself or do something for myself, I feel very selfish. I'm constantly feeling guilty, yet I want to do so many things for myself. Please tell me what to do." Monica, that is such a great question, and so many of us women feel that way. Women all over the world have been conditioned to truly sacrifice, tolerate, and all of these qualities have been given a lot of weightage while it doesn't serve us. So what I really want to do today for you is to break it down in simple steps on how to not feel selfish or remove all negativity towards anything that you want to do for yourself. So step number one would be to make a pleasure list. Why do I want you to do this? Women tend to get disconnected with their desires whenever in life we are, starting to do things for others. We get so busy in serving, in being around people and matching their expectations that we stop giving priority to ourselves. So what I really want you to do is list out things that give you pleasures. These can be small things like, you know, keeping a bouquet of flowers or going for a drive, listening to good music. Or these can be larger things like taking a vacation or going for a pedicure or whatever it is that you enjoy. The important thing here is that if our well is empty, how are we going to give anything to others? We have to first fill up our well of happiness, become the source of happiness, and then provide others. And that way we will not be frustrated, we will not be upset, we won't remove our anger on staff, children, or wherever else. This truly helps us to reconnect with pleasure. And when women work with pleasure as their direction, it really helps us not feel selfish, because we know we're doing it to eventually serve others only. Step two. Rephrase your story. Words as harsh as selfish or emotions as strong as guilt, you want to be careful, because whenever we use such harsh words, we land up feeling all of this. So you want to rephrase it to, instead of selfish, let's say self-love. Because when you give yourself love, then you are so much filled with all of that, that's what you will respond to the world then. So I really want you to start to not call yourself that. Whenever you're looking after yourself, you have to tell yourself that you're an important person. A lot of people are depending on you. And because of that, it's important to look after yourself rather than the story you're giving yourself right now. Step number three is allow your guilt to lead you. What does that mean? You know, guilt is one of the most wasted emotions, because even though we feel it, there's not much we can do about it. However, if we start to let it guide us, so I'm feeling guilty that I've not spent enough time with my children, let me use this guilt to make sure that I actually spend time with my children. You know, so whatever, let's say I've gone on this very lavish lunch with my friends and now I'm feeling guilty that I did not attend to the house, let me come back from lunch and make sure that I attend to the house. So use guilt as your guideline rather than using guilt as an emotion that creates negativity. Selfish is the world's way of putting you down, and self-love is your way of letting the world know that you're important. So Monica, what I really want to wrap up this video with is that every single day, look at your pleasure list, find 2-3 things on it that you can do for yourself, fill yourself up with love, and then go distribute that amongst everybody. I want you to rephrase your story, not use harsh words on yourself, don't be such a critic. You deserve every little thing that you do for yourself, because you're important. And lastly, allow your guilt to guide you and never carry any negative emotion towards guilt. Now, I want to hear from you. What are the things you are doing in your life that give you pleasure? All the various ideas of how you pamper yourself. Did you find this video helpful? If so, do comment now. And while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe and share with your friends. I'll see you next Wednesday on a new episode of Pooja's Perspective. We were designed with the ability to design our life. So go create a life that you absolutely love.